Many tough young men come out of Miami's Larkmont projects. Not all of them make it out, but our next inductee did and built a solid career and reputation. After a successful amateur career fighting for the Miami-Dade amateur boxing program, he would turn pro in 1982. He became a crowd favorite with his heavy punching style, scoring several eye-catching knockouts. He tried to make some desperately needed money to take care of his family and wound up working for a dealer. The dealer and the organization were taken down by law enforcement, but thanks to his clean record and his reputation, he accepted a plea offer for 18 months, while all the others wound up with sentences up to 10 years. After his release, he continued his career. He won 10 straight fights to earn back-to-back world title shots. He put Gianfranco Rossi on the canvas in round three, but couldn't finish it, and would wind up losing a 12-round decision for the IBF super welterweight title. In his next fight, he would challenge James Toney for the IBF middleweight title, but again, lost a close 12-round decision. After a loss to Roy Jones Jr., he stepped out of boxing with a final record of 27 wins, 5 losses, 1 draw, 24 of his wins by way of knockout. Fought 27 times here in the Sunshine State. These days, he's enjoying life working for a construction company in Atlanta and enjoying looking back on a very good boxing career, and we are so pleased to welcome him to our family today. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming to the Florida Boxing Hall of Fame Class of 2020, former 2-time world title challenger, Glenn Big Bad Wolfe.
I got a few people that I got to give thanks to. First one is God, at the head of my life. The second one is my lovely wife, Amanda Wolfe. If it weren't for her, she keep me grounded at all times, at all times. And I got to give thanks to a lot of you older guys probably know him. He was Bobby Brenton. He the first one started me to boxing when I was like 6 years old, but I couldn't fight until I got 10. And me coming up out of Larkmont Project, he used to just bring his gloves to the park, and we'd be walking through. Only thing we really could afford then, well, we had clothes and everything, but after we get out of school, we just wore gym shorts and a t-shirt, no shoes at all time. We ain't never had on no shoes. Anywhere we go, we can walk 20 miles away from Larkmont Project. We never have on no shoes, so our feet, we were hard. You know, we were hard. We climbed trees and ate mangoes all the time like this and like that. So he started me boxing. So one day we walk and just go to the grocery store, because we used to go to the grocery store to, like, carry people baggage to their cars when they buying grocery. They give us quarters here, dimes here. You know, that's how we was coming up, being poor in the project. So it's a lot of things that a lot of ways my life traveled, me being as old as I'm is now, because it was a rough road, real rough road. But by the grace of God, he brought me through everything. So Bobby Brenton used to tell me he'll rather take a champion that's out of shape, and he'll get a bum that's in shape. And he said that bum will beat him every time, because that bum gonna be in shape. So I took that to heart. So that's how people used to say, well, Glenn, you've been hitting with everything you've been hitting with, but he's still coming. And The reason why I learned how to become an inside fighter, which, and I was a kind of tall fighter, but a lot of people underestimated me by wanting to get on the inside of me when I fought. That's where I want you at. I had a jab and a good right hand and everything, but I'm just playing with you with this so you can come in here. So once you come in here, you at home. I can fight. I thought I used to fight like the old time fighters back then when they fought 100 and some rounds. I thought I could go 100 and some rounds the way I fought because I never got tired. And I had a good chin. Thanks to my pop right there. I met Dwayne Simpson, my third amateur fight. I was fighting, I already had three fights, but I didn't know how to fight because I was with Bobby Brenton. Only thing he used to tell me, be in shape at all time. He used to tell me, when you hit the first bell, just throw punches till you hear it ring again, then you stop. So when the bell ring, I just go out, I'm just throwing punches. I didn't have no cutoff button. Until the bell rang, I stopped, and he'd tell me something, and I'd go back and the same thing. In my third fight, I fought Kel. Some of you probably know him, Kel Robinson. My third fight, I didn't even know how to throw a jab or nothing, but I was in good shape, so I'm just out there punching. You know what I mean? And I messed around. He was a open fighter. I wasn't even an open fighter then, but I ended up getting a decision from him. And Dwayne Simpson seen me. I was 10 years old. He took me to the gym. And my pop, I call him a pop because he's just like a pop, everything to me. Marcel Clay. And I met him when I was 10 years old. And, you know, I'm in the gym and I'm saying, and he got me throwing a jab, like, you know what I mean? Jab like a whole month, just a jab. I'm asking him, you don't know I got three fights already, right? So he said, yeah, but you don't know how to fight. I said, well, after the jab for about 3 months, then it's throw the jab right hand for another 3 months. I'm saying, when? You know what I mean? And the only one I can box with then was him. He wouldn't let me box with nobody else but him. And by him being an outside fighter, only way I can get a punch in on him, I got to get on the inside. And I sparred with him since I was 10 years old till I got like 13. I started getting on the inside of him. I started getting a couple punches in because every day, he used to whoop me every day. But every day he get to the gym, I'd be right on the front step waiting on him to open because I said, one day I'm going to beat him. I'm going to get him one day. And my pop, and I love him to death. If it weren't for him, it wouldn't have never been me. And it's a whole, you know, a few more people that, you know what I mean, like Al Benanti, but I got with Al later on in my career. But Dwayne Simpson and Marcel Clay, if it weren't for those two guys, it wouldn't have never been me. But my pop right there, that's my heart. That's all I have to say. Thank you.